Hi, I'm Jason Roth. In the last video, we installed SQL Server 2008 R2. If you're new to SQL Server, you may be thinking, now what? In this video, I'll show you how to create your first database. We'll then install a sample AdventureWorks database, and we'll conclude by importing a spreadsheet into a database. This is not a video on database design, but it should give you some invaluable hands-on experience with the tools, and you can immediately begin using SQL Server. It all starts with a tool called SQL Server Management Studio. On the Start menu, click All Programs. Expand Microsoft SQL Server 2008 R2, and then start SQL Server Management Studio, also known as SSMS. SSMS is an all-purpose SQL Server tool that you will grow to depend on. First, you have to connect to your database instance. Make sure server type is set to Database Engine. Next, type the server name. If you just installed the Express Edition, then the default instance name is /SQL Express. The period represents the local machine. If you installed another edition of SQL Server, you may have installed a default instance. In that case, you could connect simply by using the period alone. Click the Connect button. In the left pane of SSMS, you can see the Object Explorer. This gives you a view of the SQL Server instance you just connected to. If you expand the Databases node, you'll see that a clean installation of SQL Server contains no user databases, but creating one is easy. Right-click on the Databases node, and then select New Database. Give the database a name, such as My Database. As with most objects in SQL Server, databases have many configurable options, but if you're just getting started, it's easier to accept the defaults. Click OK to create your new database. Object Explorer shows the My Database database you just created. If you expand this node, you'll see many subsections that help you to manage this database, but you don't have to understand or use all of these features initially. Instead, let's look only at tables. As described in previous videos, the data in your database is stored in tables. Each table is similar to a spreadsheet with rows and columns. Let's add a table to our database. Right-click the Tables node, and then select New Table. The Table Designer allows you to define the columns of your table. I'm going to create a table to track my friends' birthdays. With databases, you should always have one column to uniquely identify each row. Since I could have two friends with the same name, I'll associate a number with each friend in a column called ID. The data type of the column restricts the type of data that can go into that column. Since ID is a number, I'll set the data type to int, which stands for integer. In future videos, we'll also make this our primary key, but for now, let's just keep things simple and continue. For the first name and last name columns, set the data type to nvarchar25, which means a variable length string with a maximum of 25 characters. The birthday column can have a date data type. If the value for a column is required, then uncheck the Allow Nulls checkbox. Save the changes. In the Choose Name dialog, type Friends, and then click OK. You can now see the Friends table in the Tables section of Object Explorer. By default, all database objects are owned by the DBO schema, so the table name is displayed as dbo.friends. Of course, there's still no data in this database. Let's add some friends to our table. Right-click on the Friends table, and then select Edit Top 200 Rows. This view allows you to enter and update table data. Enter a few rows. Each time you go to a new row, the previous row is committed, which means saved. When you're done, close this editing window. Now that we have data in the table, how do we review that data? You may have noticed a trend in the tasks so far. Right-clicking in the Object Explorer provides access to most management tasks. So right-click on the Friends table, and then click Select Top 1000 Rows. This time it generates a query, which is really just a question about our data. This query requests to return the first 1000 rows of the Friends table. The results are displayed below. Queries can be a powerful tool for analyzing data. For example, I can edit this query and add a condition to show only friends whose first name starts with the letter J. We'll discuss queries more in future videos. Now that you've had some experience creating your own database, let's load up a well-designed database sample. The AdventureWorks database samples are often used in tutorials and documentation, AdventureWorks stores sample sales data for an online bicycle store. Let's look at how to install AdventureWorks on your SQL Server instance. Go to http://msftdbprodsamples.codeplex.com. Select the sample databases link that matches your version of SQL Server. In my case, it's SQL Server 2008 R2. Click the installation link and accept the license agreement. Run the installation program. Accept the second license agreement and then click Next. In the installation instance, choose a SQL Server instance. In my case, I only have SQL Server 2008 R2 Express installed, so the SQL Express named instance is my only option. Note that there are several databases that you can install. Depending on the prerequisites, you may be restricted from installing one or more of these. Click More Information next to the database to learn more. However, if you just want to get a sample database for testing and learning, you don't necessarily require all of these databases. In that case, I recommend only selecting the AdventureWorks LT database. Click Install. When complete, click Finish. In SSMS, you can press F5 to refresh the database node. You can now see and expand the AdventureWorks LT database. You already know how to select the rows in each table. For example, here are the rows of the products table. For learning purposes, you can easily examine the nodes under each table to learn more about the database design. For example, if I expand the columns of the products table, I can see all the column names and their data types. For our final example, say you have existing data like this customer spreadsheet. It's possible to import this data into a database. In SSMS, right-click on your database, click Tasks, and then select Import Data. Set the data source to Microsoft Excel. Provide the file path to the spreadsheet. Click Next several times, and then Finish. If you refresh your tables list, you'll see the imported table. All of the spreadsheet data is now in your SQL Server database. Obviously, this import process has more complexities, but we'll save that for another video. This video has just scratched the surface of what you can do with SQL Server, but you should now be more comfortable using SQL Server Management Studio to explore SQL Server and begin working with databases. In the next video, we'll look at how to write Transact SQL queries. For more information and resources, go to http://learningsqlserver.wordpress.com. Thanks for watching.